What's going on, everybody? Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be doing an overall market update, taking a look at the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, and the NASDAQ. We're also going to be doing a trading update, talking about what I personally did today in the markets, as well as some other stocks and ETFs that I'm personally watching and looking to trade heading into the month of October in 2019. We're also going to be talking about my opinion on whether or not you should buy the dip right now on the markets, this nice little dip that we've gotten here over the past couple of days. So if you guys enjoy this video, if you find value in this video, and by the way, bear with me, guys, I am a bit sick today, so my voice is a little bit off, but if you find value in this video, pretty much, feel free to go down below and hit that like button. Consider subscribing if you want to see further content for me involving the stock market and trading, and join our Discord group chat down below and our Facebook group. All of the social links are linked down below. So getting into it, guys, the S&P 500 today, the SPX, the 500 largest publicly traded U.S. companies, ended up doing quite well. You know, yesterday the markets got hit, right? We got some impeachment news regarding Trump. The markets got hit pretty badly, but today we rebounded very nicely, up about 0.62%. And if we zoom in a bit here onto, I guess you can say, this is still the 4-hour chart, but if we just zoom in a bit, you can see that this actually held, the candlesticks held on the 4-hour chart, the moving average support levels, being that 50 SMA and that 180 SMA, the 50 SMA being this green line, and the 180 SMA being this yellow line. So that's a very good sign that in the short term, we want to hold this uptrend. We want to hold this higher low, because what happened last time we touched these levels, guys, these moving averages? We gapped down, we held them, and we popped, right? At this point in time, back in the beginning of September, this was a higher low on top of the moving average. And right now, this is another higher low on top of the moving average, which leads me to believe here on a technical basis that this is simply a pullback and that it's recovering here to potentially launch itself up to new highs. One thing that is not too bad right now, but one thing that might be a problem here in the next coming days is this 2990 level of support. And it's not bad right now, because still we had a good green day today. There's still potential to go up, but ideally I would have liked it to see it close above this level at 2990, which is why it's a bit bad now. But let's say the trend continues tomorrow, I'm sure it would actually break that level and end up closing that level, which is ultimately closing above that level, which is ultimately what we need to potentially run up and test those highs at 3027. So we're about 6 points away from that right now at the time of this video, at the time of the market close on the 25th. If we break and we hold that level of support, new level of support, that could be a sign we're filling up to retest those all-time highs. And ultimately, if we break that level, guys, of course, that's going to be a new all-time high on the S&P. If we're zooming in a bit here on the 20-day, 1-hour, you guys can see the resistance a bit clearer here under 2990, and it's also putting us under a resistance on under that 180, or rather under that 50 SMA here on the hourly chart. So again, like I said a couple of seconds ago, if we break out of 2990, this is going to be ideal for the continuation of the uptrend here, and we can fill up that gap. So overall right now, guys, this market, it's reacting on some positive news regarding the trade war today. We got some news that Trump is getting closer to a deal with China, but oh boy, have we heard that so many times here before. You know, I've talked about that so many times on the channel. We've heard that so many times in the news. So is he being real this time? Is he just pulling our legs? I don't know, but still, this news, whenever we get it, I feel like it loses weight each time, because he loses his, the words lose impact, because one day he says, oh, we're coming to a trade agreement now, everything's looking great. Then the next week, there's terrible news. So, you know, your word loses weight as you continue to fall back on your word as time goes. And that's kind of how I'm viewing this whole trade war situation with Trump, because I feel like he's just saying it to pump up the stock market, and honestly, from the Chinese perspective right now, the impeachment news on Trump, this is actually, in my opinion, causing Trump and the U.S. to lose leverage in terms of the U.S.-China trade war and a potential trade deal. So maybe the president of China, maybe China in general, they wait a couple of months, try to just keep going back and forth, not come to a deal. Maybe they wait, see what happens with the impeachment. Maybe Trump doesn't get reelected in 2020, and then they make a deal with whoever does get elected due to this impeachment, right? This is something that could happen, and I think China ultimately, and I know a bunch of you agree with me, they're waiting until this election to come to a deal with the U.S. I think that's the 100% ideal scenario for them. But that's honestly just my two cents and kind of, you know, what's been going on here with, you know, Trump and what potentially popped up the markets today. But short term here, guys, in the short term, the markets do seem like they are recovering in terms of the SPX, right? That's a pretty good sign. And of course, I'd love to know what you guys have to think about that. Going to the Dow Jones, up 0.61% today, up 162 points. You can see just like the S&P, the SPX, we actually held major moving averages here on the 4-hour chart as well. Both the 50 and the 180 SMA, right? We bottomed out at that level, which was actually also a support from a couple weeks slash months ago at around $26,600. We actually broke out of the resistance at around $26,900 today as well, which is a very good sign that we're potentially going to fill the gap up to $27,200, which is around 300-ish points away from where we are now. So this is actually looking a bit more bullish than the S&P 500, in my personal opinion, since the S&P is under that $29,900 level of resistance. So the next level again, 27.2, 27.3, which is putting us close to those all-time highs. And of course, if we break out of that, you know, we may be running up obviously to an all-time high at that point, right? If we go to the 20-day 1 hour. One thing that's a bit worrisome is despite we broke 26.9, that resistance, that's a good sign. We're still trending, trading under that 50 SMA, right? This is a resistance. It's clearly a resistance over the past couple of days. So if we break this tomorrow, guys, let's say the futures are gapping up, some Dow stocks are up pre-market. This could be the sign that we're filling the gap up to those all-time highs, near those all-time highs, at least in the short term, and that's what I'm personally watching, right? And to see some intraday movement today, guys, and I'll go back to the S&P here in a minute. You know, we ended up gapping up a bit this morning. We gapped down, not really gapped down, we fell down pretty aggressively, right? And then we started to run up, and this is when the kind of the bulls took over for the day, right? Because we found a higher low from the previous at yesterday's close, near yesterday's close, and then we pushed out of that resistance at 26.9 and pretty much started making higher highs and higher lows from there. If we go back to the S&P very quickly, you guys can see very similar, right? We gapped up, we pushed down. We didn't make a higher low like the Dow. We actually made a lower low from yesterday. So at this point, this was a continuation of the downtrend, but ultimately the bulls took over here. You know, we broke out of moving average resistance levels, we made a higher high, pulled down, made a higher low, and then closed the day on that nice little swing. So it seems like this morning the bulls, the bears, they were fighting, but ultimately the bulls took over probably within the first 2 hours of the market. And you guys can see how the trend on both the Dow and the S&P really just went for the rest of the day from there. Going to the NASDAQ, very strong day today, up 1.1%, up $85 on the day. And you guys can see here, very interesting, I'm noticing something. We're getting rejected by 78.50 right off the bat here from the intraday chart. And if I zoom out a bit, you guys can see that that level is actually a resistance from back in the month of April, heading into the month of May when we saw that big sell-off in the market. So that's kind of interesting, guys, because You know, for us to fill the gap to the next resistance, which is 79.50, we obviously need to break 78.50 first to get ourselves up that 100-point gap to the next level. And if we zoom in a bit here to the 20-day 1 hour, you can see that we are struggling right now. That's putting us under the 180 SMA as well on this hourly chart. So this is something to watch for, especially if you want to see the NASDAQ go to all-time highs. This needs to break, and this needs to really just break above this resistance and that 180 simple moving average. And if we zoom in a bit even more, guys, you can see here, if I go to, let's say, the 5 day 5 minute chart, you know, you could see it even clearer, right? If we get out of this level, that's a huge gap up out of this zone, out of this channel, which should end up filling us up to the next level. So overall, guys, that's kind of what I'm thinking on the markets right now. You know, you got some insight regarding the China trade deal for me. You know, you got some insight on, you know, my thoughts on the market. Now, I want to get some insight from you guys. So drop that comment down below. Let me know, what are your thoughts on everything, the impeachment? Is it just smoke in the air? That's what some people were commenting in yesterday's video. I've been seeing that a bunch around the news and the community. I would love to know what you guys have to think. So what did I do today in terms of my trading, guys? It was kind of a slow day, but I bought some Apple this morning on the dip, and I'll show you guys where I bought Apple today, if it can end up popping up on my screen here. You guys can see this channel on Apple, right? Between 215 and around 226. I've been talking about this level, 215, being a buy zone over the past couple of videos here. The main reason is because, you know, 215 back in May, this is where we peaked and sold off, really making it a resistance level, right? And then back in August, we actually popped up to 215 again, selling off aggressively. So that's pretty much a double top over the span of a couple months there, making that a strong resistance. And then what happened after that, a couple weeks later? You know, we broke 215, hit a high at 226, making 215 a support, right? It's just a support level now because we broke the resistance, making it a new support. So now, you know, I've been talking about on these videos, you know, if we do get down to 215, I'm going to be looking at Apple as a potential buy. I know I said a swing trade, right? I'm still looking to swing trade Apple, but today I actually got in and out of Apple with a very small position. Again, due to just me wanting to see if these markets are going to continue the rally tomorrow. Tomorrow, I'd probably look to add more money into Apple, or really just add a fresh swing position. You know, if the markets do continue this rally, if the futures are green tomorrow, if large caps look good, you know, that could give me the go on Apple. But if we just zoom in a bit on the 1 day, 1 minute, you guys can see we pretty much pulled down, held 215, 217-ish. Again, it's not always going to be perfect, 215 on the dot, right? Sometimes it might be 216, 216.15. In this case, it was 217, right? So we got that bottom, you know, yesterday, about with an hour left in the market, a couple of hours left, we held 217. Pre-market today, we held 217. And once we got that the bottom here at 217 this morning, and we aggressively shot up and ultimately started riding that 50 SMA, I was like, this looks like a good short-term buy here, especially with the markets doing well at this point in time. The markets were steadily climbing pretty much after the first 2 hours of the day. Like I mentioned a couple of minutes ago, you guys saw the intraday SPX chart, and I just started buying a little bit of Apple here. You know, I scalped it off the 50 SMA, you know, on the dip. I believe I started buying in, it was like 219.20. I didn't get it ideally at the price I wanted to, which would have been down here. But at this point, you have to understand, guys, this could have very well broken below here and continued to just push down, maybe to 216, 215. So I was being a bit cautious, and I wanted to see a full-on bounce, a full-on break above moving averages, and I wanted to see it hold those moving averages before entering a position, because I wanted ultimately to see an uptrend forming before getting in. So that's what I did, 219.20, 219.25-ish, and then I just really ended up selling at this peak here, not at the peak exactly, like I knew it was going to be the peak, but I ended up selling like roughly here as it stretched out to the higher high at about 220. I think it was like 220, maybe 220.10 or something like that. And at that point in time, guys, the RSI was overbought. So that was an indicator telling me, okay, it might be a good time to sell here. And that's exactly what I ended up doing. Overall, not too crazy of a day, right? If you can see here, about a 0.5% profit today. Not bad. Not bad. That's pretty much making up for a loss that I took on a swing last week. I think the loss was on, what was it? It was on ATVI, right? ATVI, I was in at 55.10 or something like that. Took a very minimal loss there just to preserve, just for a risk purpose, because I wasn't looking to hold that one, you know, through what was going on in the market a couple of days ago when I was holding it. So I guess I made back my loss on ATVI. But that's another thing to talk about. Honestly, I might make a whole nother video on this, but you know, topics that are going on right now in the overall stock market and the overall economy, really just the overall economy, everything going on, I feel like the markets are like a roller coaster. One day they're up, one day they're down. So it's been very difficult to plan out swing trades. And let me know what you guys, maybe you guys want me to make a video on that. Let me know down below in the comments, and I would definitely consider doing that. So overall, that's what I ended up doing today in terms of my trading, guys, Apple, and segueing into some stocks that I'm watching. You know, Apple's definitely one of those stocks that I'm watching. It's breaking out of moving average resistances right now. I'm looking to potentially get in on a better, maybe a pullback here if I do end up swinging it. But again, you know, with the way the economy's been going here, affecting the stock market every day, something new, I'm kind of scared at this point to really swing trade Apple at this point, to be honest. But I think if we do break out here ultimately, and to swing trade a bunch of other stocks at that, guys, but I think ultimately if we break Apple, or this resistance on Apple, this could be a quick fill to 226. I think that's very possible if I draw this out for you guys, you know, this move being made, whether it's we pull down first and then ultimately pop, I think this is definitely something that could happen. Another stock that is interesting right now, it's a high flyer, it's been very, very hot, but it seems like it's finding support here over the past two trading days, is Roku, guys, ticker symbol ROKU. And take a look at this level on Roku at around 98 to about 100-ish dollars. That level of support was a support back in the beginning of August, right? We held it, then hit that all-time high at 176. We got some news about Comcast, their own, what's it called, streaming service or whatever it is. You guys know what I'm talking about. That crushed Roku, right? It lost from lost a ton of its value from 176 down to where it is right now. But this is a level that's interesting, because if we end up popping here, guys, and ultimately breaking back into the 110s, maybe the 110s, right? Maybe like 113, 14, 15, 16. If we get into those levels, you know, not only are we confirming the support bounce at 100, which is a very good sign, but we're also breaking above the EMA resistance, which is this light blue line. That's another good sign. And we're also breaking above just this general level of resistance between 110 and 115. And you guys saw last time we broke 115, the stock went straight to 135. I'm not saying that that's going to happen again. No one knows what the stock's going to do. But all I'm saying is, if on a technical basis here, we pop out of 115, we can be up to 130 in a couple of weeks, maybe in a couple of days, if the stock did get hot like that, because we've seen it get hot like that before. And trust me, guys, just because this Comcast news came out that rattled the stock, it doesn't mean the stock's done here indefinitely, right? There's still life in this stock. Maybe this Comcast news blows over, whatever it may be. A lot of times, stocks like this, more speculative plays, they can move irrationally regarding, or what's the word? Even if there's negative news around the stock, let's just put it that way, right? And Roku's one of those that I'm watching right now. So just keep an eye on the 115 break. That's something very, very critical in my opinion. Another one here is going to be Tesla, guys. Good old Tesla, TSLA. This one, it's pretty simple. You guys can see on the trend here, we've been downtrending, but slowly we've been breaking out of these moving average resistances. Really from the beginning, I guess you could say from the beginning of June, right? That's when we started this little uptrend to break out of the moving average resistances here on the 4-hour chart. It's been a good sign there since then, right? We hit the low at 176. We hit a high at about 265. If you swing traded it from there, you made some good money, right? And then we ended up pulling down, holding this trend line at 211, which was a higher low. That's a good sign that the uptrend is continuing. Right. And now we actually failed to hit a higher high. We actually ended up hitting a lower high, putting us in this wedge because now we're hitting this point of support on the trend line again at a higher low. So we're hitting higher lows at the same time as we're hitting lower highs, putting us in this wedge. So right now, especially since today, Tesla was up nearly $6, about 2.5%, and we're holding this level. Right now, I think there's a good chance that we could end up seeing a bit of a rally here on Tesla if we do end up breaking this 180 SMA resistance tomorrow, right? This is a good technical play here, in my opinion, from here up to about 240, maybe 242. And if we zoom in, excuse me, guys, again, I am sick. I am sniffling at the time that I'm recording this video. So leave a like, guys. If you've never left a like, this is the video that you should leave a like because I am a sick guy today. But anyway, you know, we may be going up here to test that 50 SMA. You know, breaking out of that 50 SMA could lead us to gap up to, again, that 242 level. So that's kind of what I'm watching right now for Tesla heading into tomorrow. So overall, guys, that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, again, leave a like. I would greatly, greatly appreciate that. Drop a comment down below. Let me know your thoughts on the market. What are your thoughts on the impeachment right now? And by the way, on the impeachment, forgot to mention this earlier, two previous presidents that went through this process were Nixon and Clinton. And when the stock market's reaction to Nixon, although I was reading it was already in almost a recession at that point, the stock market was going down when that impeachment process was happening. But on the flip side for Clinton, the stock market was going up, right? The stock market was booming as he was getting, put through this impeachment process. Just a fun fact out there because I forgot to mention it a couple of minutes ago. So if you enjoy the content, again, guys, subscribe to the channel, join all the, social links, Discord, Facebook, Instagram, all those are down below. I'll catch you all in the next video. Thanks again for watching. I appreciate every single one of you guys out there. Peace out.